evening, everybody. This is Bob Cole, and with me is John Garrett. And out there at center ice, the referee, Bill McCreary, with the linesman, Gord Brossiger and Swede Knox. McCreary will have this seventh game underway in just a moment. Former goaltender in the National Hockey League, John Garrett. A lot of pressure on goaltenders. This 22-year-old, it's a brand new thing for him.
This is his first seventh game, and there's not as much pressure on him. The Canucks aren't even supposed to be in a seventh game, let alone Kirk McLean playing in it.
Mike Vernon has been in this situation before, but I wonder if this game is the biggest.
This is the biggest. Again, they have to shake that reputation they've had of blowing playoffs.
Person. And McGinnis start in the defense for Calgary. Otto, McDonald, and Papinski are up front. Adams is in with the first shot. And Vernon got the stick down to steer it into the corner. Lyndon Smeal and Adams start. Here's McDonald coming in. He's in around the net, trying to wrap it around and knock it in. He falls to the ice. Smeal coming back to center ice. Smeal going in, dropped it back to Reinhardt. A high shot, and that just missed. Off the boards to McDonald again. Coming in. McDonald passes back. Morrison took a shot and he just missed. Good scoring chances already. Back for Greg Adams. He's in there one-on-one. And he was tied up by McGinnis, who played him all the way. McGinnis didn't even look at the puck. Stepped right into his man. McGinnis coming back. In around his own net, Vernon took it with his stick and cleared it into the corner. That's Patterson coming out. Flipped it ahead for Gilmore. Mullen coming up. The sharpshooter in with a drive. A low shot, and McLean got a piece of it. Cleared back out to center. A long lead pass. Just failed to work. Flames. Gilmore steals it from Snepps. Coming in. Snepps caught up to him. Skriko has it. The Canucks, Skriko got as far as his own line. Then Bradley took a hit from Mullen before shooting it in. Bradley again gets in position. He can't shoot it. Rolled it in front of the net, and Matras clears it out to Mullen. Across center. Mullen coming in. Tried to beat the defense on the far side. Benning tied him up on the boards. Jim Benning got a skate down on it, and they hold it there. Now it comes loose. Gets it away. No icing. It was tipped at the blue line by Natras. Just over 2 minutes gone as Linden intercepts. He's bodied by Roberts. Here's Lube coming in. Flipped it in front of the net. Oh, Neuwendijk came close. Neuwendijk in the corner. This crowd, you can tell they are tense too. Slapped on the boards. Not out. Now it is. Lube takes it again. Shoots it in for the Calgary Flames. Nordmark. Pass to Adams. Brink wide to Smeal. Dropped it through the middle. Linden played it in. Neuwendijk number 25 for the Calgary Flames. A long lead pass. Lube just failed to hang on to it. He turns away from his check. Butcher got it back. Otto flipped it in front. Reinhardt was covering up for Vancouver. It up as far as center ice. The play is called on a glove pass. Otto and Bridgman nearly go at it.
The Calgary Flames battered up. Vancouver has some injuries. Barry Peterson's out for the year with an injury, as is David Bruce. The other one scratches Ken Berry, Kevin Guy. Ron Stern has a sore neck. Larry Melnick had thumb surgery. For the Calgary Flames, Gary Suter with a broken jaw. Mark Hunter broke his right hand in game six. He's out for the year. Yuri Herdina, Ken Sabourin, and Sergei Priyakov.
And no score at the 3 minute mark of period number one in game number seven. Who would have thought the Canucks would be here playing the first place Calgary Flames in the seventh game? They're here, very much here. Bozak in with a shot. Was blocked before it got to Vernon. A Flames player injured in behind the play. Near the line was Tim Hunter. He went down in a heap. He's on the bench. So that's good news for the Flames. He has not gone to the dressing room. From the blue line, Reinhardt shot. blocked in front of the net. It's chopped away by Roberts all the way down the ice, and this will be icing with Reinhardt coming back. And the faceoff will be back inside the Calgary line.
Tim Hunter with an ice pack on his thumb, sitting on the bench. Looks to be all right. Didn't go to the dressing room for repairs. Chances are he'll be back. Tim Hunter set up a beautiful goal in game six. A Jim Poplinski goal, the trainer of the Calgary Flames, Bearcat Murray.
Person number five comes off the bench. And the big guy is out there for Calgary. Ozak is 14 with Bridgman to his left. The puck goes in behind the net. Bridgman in to hit his man. It's Roberts shooting it from center ice. McLean comes out of the net to clear it up on the boards for Sandlack. He gets it out. Ozak gets a break and hit him on the shins. He's going in. Trying to cut for the net. One hands it across in front of the goal. Reinhardt on the boards. Can't keep it in. Nieuwendyk is away, and he has Roberts catching up. Nieuwendyk, up by Roberts, going in. Here's Loob. Hook and Loob centered an empty net, and nobody could get a shot. Reinhardt for the Canucks up the center. Tanny is going to pick it up with Bozak. There's Bozak. He didn't see Tanny go the other way. There's Tanny. Oh, and a save by Vernon. Tanny. He has not scored in so long, and he had the open side, he thought, but Vernon made a beautiful save.
He had some great chances in game six and was robbed by Mike Vernon. This one, he doesn't get wood on it at all. Bozak, good speed around Al MacInnis, then he's hit by Roberts. Good solid hit by Roberts. Calgary, Hogan Lund sets it up, and they do have an empty net, but Roberts and Nieuwendyk both go by this puck in front. Lube, a good move around Butcher, sets it up for Roberts and Nieuwendyk. McLean's out of the net. They can't find the handle. Canucks get away again. Tony Tanny misses this one. You see, he gets under it, and Vernon is able to come across. If Tanny gets good wood on that one, Vernon doesn't even have time to move.
Great save, though, by Mike Vernon. He got his glove up, and the only spot he wanted, right there, was the puck. So, no score. 4 minutes, 23 seconds into the first period. Shot from the line by Litzker, didn't get too far. Tanny in back of the net, can't find it. Mullen picks it up for Calgary and lifts it into the center ice area, rolls in. Litzker turning, Gilmore watching him. On the boards, down the ice, no icing, it has been waved off. Natras comes back, slides it ahead to Patterson, he is stopped. Canuck forechecking now, stopped at the line. Adams goal is picked up right away. Now snaps, he has to back up. Lidstrom takes it, gives it to Tanny. Tony Tanny across center, the long shot, gloved by Vernon. Antlers behind the goal, and he was upended. Tried to sidestep a check, it didn't work. Adams keeping it in, don't get a shot, shoots it in there in the crease area. Patterson out for Calgary to Mullen. Mullen to center. Back to Patterson to Mullen again. Mullen fired it in for Patterson, and he was covered on the play by Jim Benning. Now he gets it to Mullen. Mullen faked the shot. Now he goes in again. Rolled it up in front of the net. Mullen gets it a third time on the boards. After Ramage's shot is blocked. It's another shot. Big pressure by Calgary now. In back of the net. Puck lifted out into the corner by Gilmore. Gilmore tied up. Pinching in, but Crennan tried to get it back. He is stopped. A touch and grab in on the boards. Puck comes to Gilmore again on his skates. Patterson missed it. Ravage coming in and can't stop it. And the Canucks, boy, do they come back and cover up in front of the net. And not much room to move and maneuver. Looked as if the Flames had some chances for a shot or two, but nobody could really get it in decent position. 13:43 left in the first period in this one. Game seven, the Canucks and the Flames. Nieuwendyk gets it off the boards and lifts it out of the zone and down the ice. Canucks come back. This is Grieco getting it away. He took it from Sutter and then lifted one in. Merzen turns around the net, gets it up into the center ice area again. You can see they're tentative. Close checking. Long lob into the zone. It bounces right to McLean. Those things will give you fits sometimes. Adams had to hurry his pass. Goes down the ice. Vernon will play it. McGinnis back. Leads it out for Kopinski out of his reach. Comes in front of the net. The goaltender had to play it with McDonald coming in front. McLean was looking for an icing call, but he had to play it with a good hustle shown by Larry McDonald. Lidstrom behind the goal. Smeal takes a look around. Here comes McClellan to hit him. Linden trying to blow in his net to the ice. McDonald took him down. Smeal kept it in. Trying to fire one over it in front of the net. McDonald gets it out, but the pass was too far. McDonald was hit hard by Linden. The rookie number 16 going after McClellan now. Without the helmet. Linden in for checking. Here's the pass to Fleury. This is his first shift. And he's wired. Here he goes. In front of the net. And it was hooked away by a skate. Fleury again left it there. Got it back. Threw it over to the far corner. Snaps went in to hit Fleury. Pressure by the Flames again. A penalty coming up. Fleury is nailed in the crease area. Right out in front of McLean. And the first penalty of the game has been called against the Vancouver Canucks.
The first penalty, first power play opportunity for the Calgary Flames. The first penalty against the Canucks. Harold snaps on Theron Fleury in front of the net. Away from that play, they check for blood. Steps only gets 2 minutes, and the Flames go on the power play.
High-sticking penalty to Harold Snaps. Calgary 8-4-34 in the series. With a man advantage. And here's their opportunity to get the first goal of the game. Tapped out across the line. McGinnis back. Ripped it in and went high. Got up on the glass and over on this side. Canucks trying to clear it. Was Bozak. Lidstra got a stick on it. He fires it away. Sutter is coming up on the play. But the goaltender Vernon out. Leaves it for McGinnis. Calgary power play led by McGinnis now. At center and shoots it in. Mullen picks it up on the boards. Lost it. Here's Robbins getting set. Stopped by McLean. He'll pass it around on the outside now. Try to spring somebody loose again. It's McGinnis first. Didn't shoot it. Gilmore slides it in front of Vernon. Weak shot by Otto. He tried to put it in to Mullen in the crease. Otto takes it again. Couldn't center it to Gilmore. Canucks hanging on, and they get it out and down the ice.
You really have to wonder about Joel Otto trying to pass that puck. He was in perfect position for the shot and tried to set up Joey Mullen.
McGinnis, again, he's the guy who leads it in, shooting it on the boards. McGinnis couldn't stop it. Now he does and rolled it ahead. Lou, with McGinnis waiting at the blue line. He left him. McGinnis drives a hard one.
Take Newendike's stick.
shoot it. Taddy picks it up and slides it to the right side. Gilmore intercepting and comes back in for Calgary. Roberts going for the net. Gilmore trying to hit him with the pass. Roberts behind the goal, wrap around. Another chance for him. He's upended in front of the net. Richmond's pass, stopped by McCown. Taddy takes it, ahead to Richmond. He's going in there with a full head of steam. And the backhand shot is blocked by Vernon. McCown back out. Fleury sidesteps a hit. Fleury coming in, himself. And testing McLean. Fleury knocks it down. Here comes Nefris. Stopped by McLean. Bozak lost it. Hunter's shot is wide of the net. It bounces all the way down the ice. 1 minute in Calgary. The crowd seem to be enjoying it. Look out! Oh, what a chance! Sandlot came around the net and nearly poked it in. There's a pass offside up to Sandlot.
The fans involved, and I think that helps the Calgary Flames get involved. We saw what a big factor that was in Vancouver in Game 6. It could be the same thing here for the Calgary Flames.
8:43 remaining in the period. New England, the power play goal from Ruben McGinnis. 1-0 Calgary. Jim Benning on the draw, gets it ahead to Adams. Decides to shoot it in. Smeal couldn't catch up to it. It's knocked down over on the boards. Right, hit his man hard. Popinski is coming in there. Popinski centered it. And McLean had to be careful with the shot. Otto was falling, but got a stick on it. McLean was on that side.
The Calgary Flames going to the net a lot better tonight than they were in Game 6. Their forwards had a very lethargic game in Game 6. Joel Otto, good chance on Kurt McLean, showing his strength, spinning around and letting the one-hand shot go. Otto has played an awful lot in this series. You have to wonder if he's getting a little tired. He's played more than any of the other Calgary Flames. Otto gets one chance and spins around one hand on the stick. McLean very sharp to stop and control the rebound.
Bradley, number 10. Neuendijk will likely come in to take the faceoff against Bradley. There he is, 25. Talking to both wingers. Roberts and Lube didn't do any good because he failed to win the draw. Now Butcher. Played it out. Bradley through center ice. Squid goes up with him. Bradley at the line was given a bump by McGinnis. Pulling after it at the side of the net. McGinnis takes over around the goal for Roberts, who shoots it to center again. Reinhardt bounces it past to Spreeko. One good move on Roberts. Spreeko got in. Sutter is upended, and a penalty will be handed out on that play. Sutter was upended, and the Flames, a tripping penalty.
Sticks his foot out, his left foot. You can see him kick the feet out to Rich Sutter and takes the tripping penalty.
The only goal of this game came on a power play for the Flames when Neuendijk scored at 9:34. Now Vancouver 5-41 in the series with the man advantage. Reinhardt stopped it at the line and then lost it. Ducks had to come back. Upended. Crowd didn't like that. Taddy dropped it back. Now Adams for center and shoots it in. Vernon out of the net, stopping it. Taddy is coming in. It's ripped away. Got to the line, not off. Linden makes a move or two. Now the pass back and the shot score. High shot by Nordmark. And they get that goal right back on a power play of their own. High shot by Nordmark as Vernon started down.
Taddy does does a good job on this play right in front of Mike Vernon. And Reinhardt Nordmark again, the offensive power of the Canucks. A perfect pass from Reinhardt to Nordmark. There's Tony Tanney right in front of Mike Vernon. Vernon didn't see the shot. A good hard shot by Nordmark. He takes it on his forehand. That's why he can tee it up. And it goes by Mike Vernon.
12:44, the time of the goal by Nordmark. 1-1 is the score. Each team now with a power play goal. Seventh game. Winner take all in this series tonight. And on to the division final. Don't forget, right after this game, we'll send you down to Los Angeles for game number 7 between the Kings and the Edmonton Oilers. McCrimmon played it ahead to the blue line. Gilmore looking for a hole. Gives it to Mullen to the line. McCrimmon shot block. Gilmore coming right in there. And he nearly did it himself. But he fell in front of the net. Not to the ice. But nearly put the backhander into the far corner as he was going down. Good effort by Gilmore. Zanlak ripped it in on the boards. Adams takes his shot. That hit the side of the net. Adams giving a bump, and the Flames chop it away and down the ice. That's Butcher behind the goal. Tellum stepped in front to watch him. Pass comes out to Reinhardt, and he decides to stay there with it. Reinhardt getting away from Merzen, and Merzen caught up to him. Fleury had a stick lifted. Puck hit a stick and bounced behind the goal, and it's Tim Hunter getting it down the ice. Tanny comes back. Under 6 minutes to play in this first period. 1-1 is the score. Reinhardt couldn't knock down a high pass. Merzen moved up to the line. Canucks line up there on the blue line. Stand right up to the Flames. They do not get too much room to come in. Lance goes out. Into the middle of Snap. Snap Saturday. Adams was in front of the net, but net was intercepted the pass. Merzen takes it from him, gets it up to the line. McCullum dropped it to Fleury. Fleury is going in there again. Put on the brakes as DeBeck handed off into the corner, and McLean came out of the net to stop it. Look out! Nearly a giveaway in front of the goal to Roberts. Skriko backhands it off the boards behind the net. Sutter, bumped by Roberts. Flames come in hitting now. Lube in the corner trying to get the puck off the boards. And they hold it there. Sutter and Roberts pushing and shoving. 4:59 remaining in the period. Roberts and Sutter get minor penalties. Jerry Crisp and Bob McCammon in game 7. And they're locked into one. They're tied at 1. 4:59 remaining. Face-off to the right of Kirk McLean. Reinhardt and Linden assisted on Nordmark's tying goal at 12:44. Two goals scored on a power play tonight. Neuendijk for Calgary, Nordmark for Vancouver. Canucks do not get it out. Sandlock's pass is blocked. McClellan chasing Butcher. Cut to the line and a high shot just missed. Butcher lost it at the side of the net. Lube is in there digging it out now. He took a hit. Butcher slides a pass ahead. Bozak stepping to center ice. Bozak coming in. He has Brixton up on the play, and he goes around the net, bumped into the goaltender, Mike Vernon, likely. Lube at center. Pass through the middle. Neuendijk shoots it in. And Butcher comes back. Calgary Flames will make changes as Butcher takes his time. Gets it up near the line and through center. Pass goes his way. Otto went sprawling in the center ice area. Lube still on there to Otto. Lube was stopped from getting a shot. And Butcher gets it out of the zone and down the ice. 4 minutes left in the period. Kopinski coming in for Calgary. Kopinski was stumped and lost possession. Steele, a pass too far for Linden down the ice. Adams coming up looking for it. It's Kopinski waiting for it. He left it there. Now McDonald just missed the pass. Tried to get it out of the air. McDonald in after it, but it's scooped out off the boards, and Ramage dropped it back. McKrimmon again shoots it in for Gilmore. He was offside. Let the Canucks go back to pick it up, so they get a chance to move it. They do. Benning, pass to the right. Nordmark comes up and got it up over the Calgary blue line. Adams is on it first and finds a little room on the far side. Adams coming in. Four Flames were back. Linden could not catch up. Here's Patterson with Gilmore. Patterson coming in with Mullen. And Gilmore, he is stopped by McClain. Linden will pick it up. Now watch him go. He gets a chance to move it. He got as far as center and just fired it in. Obviously, the Canucks want to make changes. That's just what they're doing as the puck goes over the glass and into the crowd with 2:49 left in the period. Full CBC network. Adams to center ice. Long shot. And Vernon careful, making the stick save. 2.5 minutes remaining in the period. Icing is going to be called in this one with Reinhardt back, and we're down to 2:25 left. This game is fairly even, John.
Paul Reinhardt picking up an assist on that power play goal. He's played an awful lot in the series. He's one of those five Calgary Flames that came over to the Vancouver Canucks.
When I say even, of course, they're tied on the board, but the shots are close. 12 to 8. And the checking is rather close. The tentative, no question. And this crowd, I cannot believe it. Sometimes you can almost hear a pin drop.
This is the Vancouver Canucks style of game. This is the way they wanted the seventh game to be played.
20,062 here tonight. A complete sellout. They even added a few seats. Sold them. Well, the Flames scored first on a power play. The Canucks tied it. Here's Lewandowski. He scored that goal going in. Lewandowski and Lube. Lube picks it up off the boards, and McGinnis has that big shot. Oh, and he hit in behind. The referee has the arm up. Vernon is off. Is a penalty being called? I don't know if that went off the crossbar or not, but Lube says it was in. It certainly went by McLean. Terry Crisp says it went in the top corner.
Linesman Gord Brossaker is talking to Bill McCreary on this one. It came out like it went in, and that's why Hogan Lube is complaining. What a shot by Al McGinnis.
Oh, he drilled it. You could hardly see it, really, and we might be able to see it a little better this time. It was a high shot. McGinnis loaded up and fired. Watch.
McGinnis lets it go. It hits somebody in front, goes up underneath the bar. Yes, it's in.
That's in, baby. The red light did not go on. Now, we're in a seventh game. We're in the Stanley Cup series, and there's McCreary on the phone to the goal judge. They'll talk it over.
A case for video replay. I think that hit Gary Roberts, who was sprawled in front. There was a penalty coming up on the Canucks for knocking Roberts down. It hit him, went up into the net behind Kirk McLean.
The off-ice officials tonight are from Edmonton, and that's one of them back there, and it's a goal. Of course, McLean doesn't like the call. Chris loves the call, and 20,000 are in agreement. What a win in.
When it comes up that fast, you're playing goal, and I've done it many times in my not-so-illustrious career. You look like nothing happened. Jack naturally had hoped that they figured it hit the crossbar. Here's a different angle. The shot from McGinnis. Roberts is knocked down in front. It hits somebody in front. Up. You can see it hit right in the back of the net right there. There's the puck.
Here's the shot again by McGinnis. Boomed it from just inside the blue line. You'll see it hit something down low. Go up high, underneath the crossbar, and out again like another goal. And the goal judge down there is still blinking. But it went in. We all saw everybody across the nation. Stan Smeal didn't get an opportunity to see that replay. But Stan, you'll see it later, and you'll say, well, okay. Him around, but McCreary, the referee, had to disallow a goal, or in fact disallowed a goal in Edmonton on Thursday night. This one, after talking it over, says it had to be in. Well, he was right. It was in. 2-1 Calgary. And the goal is credited to Roberts. That's his first. McGinnis and Lube assisting. 18:01 the time. And a big goal it was. With a minute and a half left in the period, the Flames have a one-goal lead. Down the ice it goes. Vernon tapped it away into the corner, and Lube brings it out. Lube skating away to center with Otto, coming in with Roberts. This one is deflected, but it goes 20 rows back, up behind Kirk McLean.
Gary Roberts had trouble in the first two games of this series, taking mindless penalties, has become more self-disciplined, is rewarded by going to the net, off his legs, up underneath the bar, gets his first goal in these playoffs.
Big goal for Roberts and the Flames, with only 1:20 left in the period. And it's a 2-1 lead for Calgary here in Game 7. And after this one, down to Los Angeles, where you'll see the Los Angeles Kings and the Edmonton Oilers in their Game 7. Our Hockey Night in Canada doubleheader on CBC for you tonight. Reinhardt watching the puck come to Lube. Now he tries to stop Lube and can't do it. Lube had Otto in front and failed to hit him with the pass. Reinhardt gets away from Otto. Comes out with a long pass onto the skate of Sandlot. Up to Bozak into the final minute of the period. Bozak in the slot area. Couldn't get a shot through to the net. It was blocked in front of Vernon. Lube of the Flames is skating out with it again. He's knocked down by Sandlot. Reinhardt around the net. 40 seconds to play in the period. Patterson bumped Butcher. Then McGinnis ahead to Neuendijk. Neuendijk, a great move going in. Neuendijk failed to get a shot, though. Puck came back to the goal. They fight for it. Bridgman comes back to kick it loose, and he's trying to get away. Bridgman skates to center with 20 seconds to play in the period. Given a bump, and no room over there. And McCown was knocked down. McCown back into the play, though, to pick it up and skate away with it. McCown and Otto go in. Long shot stopped by McLean. Lidster around the net. 5 seconds to play. He'll kill the clock going the other way with it. And the horn goes to end of the first period. Bob Cole and John Garrett in the broadcast booth. Kirk McLean and Mike Vernon ready to go in the second period. Vernon making 7 stops in period 1. McLean had a dozen saves. So the score is 2-1. Calgary leading Vancouver in this Game 7. Neuendijk and Roberts scoring for the Flames. Nordmark for Vancouver.
In those 7 saves of Mike Vernon was that gigantic save on Tony Tanney right in front of the net, and a save on Jim Sandlack, or the Canucks could have a 3-2 lead at this time.
Hogan Lube with 2 assists in tonight's game on the 2 Calgary goals is now the leading scorer for the Flames in this series with 8 points, 5 goals and 3 assists. He's on the ice to start the second period with Neuendijk and Roberts. Up here to the line and Sandlack shot gloved by Vernon. Sandlack going after it in the corner with Bozak. Sandlack gets it centered in. Oh, and Vernon makes a big save on Bridgman. And then another. He's flat on the ice. But he made another stop. Another terrific save by Mike Vernon.
Mel Bridgman right in front, set up by Jim Sandlack. And Vernon, good lateral movement. Watch Vernon come across and make the save on Bridgman. And then the rebound, he's down. Bridgman tries to interfere. Vernon has a presence of mind, staying square to the puck, and makes the save.
Vernon again shutting down the Vancouver Canucks. They do not get many chances, and the way they have played this game, they don't need many scoring chances. Vernon was very sharp. 2-1, Calgary. Face off to the right of Vernon. And it's Mullen taking over. Banked it off the boards for Patterson. He got it out to center ice. Gilmore was checked by Sandlack. Sandlack poked at it. Patterson hit him. Mullen picked it up from behind and goes in. Mullen gives it off to Patterson. And McLean made the nice stick save. Bridge went back there, bumped by Patterson, who fell to the ice. Reinhardt for Vancouver. Butcher slides it ahead. Sandlack tried to kick it loose to Bozak and could not. Mullen turns up to Gilmore. Turning around near center, Kopitsky takes the pass and got it in over the line. The Flames were making changes in behind the play. Fired down the ice by Butcher right on the net. Vernon steps out and then passes it ahead. Otto nearly ran into Kopitsky. That's icing against Calgary. With just a minute 20 gone in the period.
Mike Vernon moved that puck up quickly. It's very hard to make changes here in the Saddle Dome in the second period for the Vancouver Canucks. They tried to catch the Canucks on that change. The pass went for icing.
This has been a good line for Calgary tonight. Neuendijk, Roberts, and Lube. Lube with two assists. Roberts, the tip-in, you remember, the shot by McGinnis at the blue line. That went in and out so fast, the goal judge apparently had difficulty seeing it. They ironed it out, though, and in fact it was in under the crossbar on the pipe at the back. Here Snepps a shot, a weak one off the skate. Snepps is playing hurt tonight and not playing a lot because of that. Lobbed in over the net. McCrimmon picking up. Play called. Sutter is knocked to the ice. And it's Ramage, I believe, who will be getting a high-sticking penalty.
With the goals coming on power plays, you can't afford to take stupid penalties. Ramage lifts his stick over Sutter's head. Unfortunately, there was no blood. Only a two-minute high sticking penalty for Rob Ramage.
So Linden with Adams and Tandy. Nordmark and Reinhardt. The Vancouver power play. Their goal came with a man advantage situation. That's when Robert Nordmark got a goal at 12:44 in the first. Nordmark carries the puck to center and shoots it in. Vernon tipped it up on the board, but Adams saw that. He was back there quickly. Back to the line to Reinhardt. Reinhardt passed it along the board. Linden shot, he scores! Linden drifting a shot and hit something in front of the net goal. However, it's tied, another power play goal for Vancouver.
The Canucks two for two. There is some towel power here for the Canucks. They take away the cross ice pass and there's Linden just lets it go through Rick Natras. Natras goes out, tries to block the shot, misses it. No chance for Mike Vernon again. A perfect screen. Linden scores from well out.
2:04, the time of the goal. Vancouver back in a tie at two. A power play goal for Trevor Linden. His third of this series. So they've proved nothing so far. They're still tied. Tied in a series. Tied in the seventh game. Second period. Sandlack now moving up. But the play had been called with sticks a bit high. McClellan and Bozak.
Steve Bozak knows what comebacks are all about. He played on that LA team that upset the Edmonton Oilers back in 82 when they finished 48 points behind the Oilers. Canucks 43 points behind the Flames coming into this series.
Lindstrom at center. Gave it to Snepps. Harold Snepps shoots it in and he was hit by Fleury. Bounces in front of the net. Bozak giving chase. It'll be Merzen who starts it away with McClellan taking it out to center. McClellan shoots it in on the net. Lane gloved it. Backhands it off the boards for Sandlack. Sandlack pulled it ahead. Tim Hunter went in after his man and Bozak saw him in time. Here's McClellan picking it up. Nobody on him. Now Snepps is there. And the goaltender McLean had to scoop it away. Kept in by the Calgary Flames as McGinnis knocked it off to the corner. Tim Hunter turning around with it along the boards for McLean. Snepps bumping with him. Snepps gets the puck away. Canucks having a tough time getting it out though. Snepps is hit hard from behind by McLean. And bowled over. He is slow to get out. Vancouver bench. The Flames move out. Steps hobbles off to the bench. They shoot it in. Reinhardt was there first, so icing has been called against the Calgary Flames.
Harold steps into this game with a bad back. Fleury takes a hit. Sneps was able to stay on with the smaller player hitting him, but Brian McClellan hit him down in the Vancouver zone, and Sneps is in pain sitting on the bench.
Reinhardt and Adams assisted on the Linden tying goal here in the second period. 2-2 the score. Flames trying to move it. And it's Lube again with Nieuwendyk and Roberts coming in. Nieuwendyk giving some room and a shot kicked away. Roberts kept it in. Nieuwendyk behind the net. There goes Hoekenlue. He picks it up, trying to give it to Nieuwendyk, but he was covered by Bradley. Butcher feeds it pass ahead. That goes down the ice. It was tipped, though. Icing waved off, but apparently hit the count. Roberts steps away. Lube is up there with it. Nieuwendyk catching up. Here's Lube. Coming in, cheats. The high shot just missed. Now Reinhardt for the Canucks. Bradley, one good move. Moving away from Lube. Bradley going in, trying to stick handle his way around McCown, but McCown took the puck away from him. Adams blasts it back in. McDonald going over there. Bucking with Lipster. There's McDonald coming out. Pass to Poplinski. Trying to go in. Poplinski dropped it back. McCown! And he missed it up by a couple of feet. Here's Doug Smith coming back out. He tried to play it up and did to Adams, but he was offside on that play.
Ryan McDonald wearing the assistant captain letter on his sweater tonight. In the only other game he pressed, he wore the C. Decided to wear the A. There's McDonald. He had some spirit, and as Jim Poplinski said in his interview, some calm in that dressing room, and the Flames in Game 7 need all the poise they can get.
Well, they're in a dogfight with these Vancouver Canucks. Underdogs coming into the series, no question. But the series is tied at 3 games each. We're in the second period, and this 7th game is tied, 2 goals apiece. And it's the Canucks controlling on the faceoff. Lidster shot off the boards to the right of Mike Vernon. Gilmore was bumped, can't move on it. Adams there. Gilmore takes it away from him. Smith didn't see it. Mullins gets away with Patterson, and Burleson is trailing. Mullins trying to find some room to go in. He falls to the ice. Patterson in there quickly to pick it up for Calgary. Left it behind the net. And it's Lidster taking over. Out to Smith. Steele is on the move. To the right of Smith. He takes the shot. Converted, an easy save. Patterson starting Gilmore. Gilmore looking around as he goes in. He dropped it back to Burleson. Backhand shot. And that's blocked by Kirk McLean as the Flames come rushing in. Bob Cole with John Guerin, Steve Armitage, Ron McLean, Don Cherry. And a Hockey Night in Canada doubleheader for you tonight. This game, and when this one is over, the other 7th game, which is down in Los Angeles, the Kings and the Oilers, on the full CBC network. You love hockey? You got it made tonight. 5:38. Gone in the second period. 2-2 the score. The surprising Vancouver Canucks. Sandlack tipped one to center. Bridgman hooked it away neatly. Bozak going in. And the low shot stopped by Vernon. He was standing up all the way, and the play is called now. With the Calgary player on the puck on the far side.
Good save by Mike Vernon, even though Bozak didn't get a lot on the shot. Has been a welcome addition to the Vancouver Canucks. Played in Switzerland, was signed before the season started. They knew they'd get him. One hand pass to Bozak. McGinnis has played well on defense tonight. A couple of times one-on-one with forwards. McGinnis just watched the man, took him to the corner.
Vernon very steady on that rush. by Vancouver.
That was a good low shot, and it came very quickly. Duvendek and Roberts wanted to come on, but the final shift has been made, and Terry Crisp insists he has one more. But the boss of the situation, McCreary, the referee, says no, no more. But you got, you got. They line up to the right of Vernon for this faceoff. Fleury against Bozak, Reinhardt shot. Nice top save by Vernon. And one was heading for the far corner. Vernon made a good glove save. Bridgman keeping it in. The Canucks pressing back of the net. Bozak centered it. Right in front of Bridgman. And he couldn't quite get a shot. Fleury stick handles out of the zone and goes in. Fleury winds up. Doesn't shoot it. Keeps going. He tried to center it there. The net is off the magnets. That will stop the play for a faceoff in the Vancouver zone. We were told that this series would be over a long time ago. It's very much alive here at the Olympic Saddle Dome tonight. Nordmark has the puck around his own net. Flipped the pass on the boards. It gets out. Tanny didn't see it in time. And Nordmark comes back. Danny McDonald watching him from the front of the net. McDonald trying to hit his man before he passed it and missed him. Linden carries on. Trevor Linden up over the line. Played it back. E.J. Nordmark. They cut back a rebound. But the play had been called. Vernon had made the stop. It came loose, but the whistle was gone.
Robert Nordmark has two goals already in this series, set up perfectly. Three goals in this series, 5 points. The defense has really come through for the Canucks, set up by Trevor Linden. Linden gets so much respect, it's unbelievable. The defense back in every time he carries the puck.
Faceoff will be up in the Calgary zone to the left of Vernon. That's Jim Benning on the bench. Slight nick over the left eye. Kopinski dances out of the zone to center. McDonald is going up there with it. Lanny McDonald trying to go in. But it's playing to Linden. Trevor Linden gets out of the zone with Tanny. Tanny flipped it in there. And Vernon saw Linden coming in a hurry, so he left the net. Kopinski backing up. Goes around the net to McDonald in the corner, and along the boards he got it out. McDonald and Otto move it up, and Tanny stopped it. Butcher picks it up. Fired it to Tanny at center. Tanny shoots it in. Linden was nailed at center by Otto. Here's McGinnis. Trying to pass it through. It goes in around the net. Lou was the first one in. Butcher is there with him. And the play is called. The offside, they'll bring it all the way back. They're the favorites of this one, and they do have trouble. They're tied 2-2 with the Vancouver Canucks coming up to the 8-minute mark of the second period. Bradley tipped it to the line. The style of the Canucks continues. Play it safe if you can, and hope it's close, and get a break if you can. Well, it's 2-2 at this moment. Lube coming in, dumped it off behind the net. McLean comes out to help it along to center. Sutter got away from Roberts that time and played it up to center ice. Streetko wasn't there in time. Neuwendijk trying to go in. It's broken up. Streetko reaching for it. Canucks fire at the center, and Roberts will wait. Neuwendijk is back onside. He shoots it in. Lipster going around the net. Lipster and Jim Benning, the defenseman, and it's Benning who played it out, but right onto a Flames stick. Mantis got it right back in. Sutter's pass onto the skate of Streetko. He's in, though. Now he's tied up by Mantis, and Mullen turns. Out with Gilmore. Gilmore coming in with Mullen. Gilmore tried to go in himself, and it was knocked away by the goaltender. Smeal through center to Streetko. Puts a high one in for Vernon as the Canucks make changes. Intercepted by Reinhardt. Couldn't get a shot. Patterson feeds it ahead. Mullen and Gilmore bring it in. Back to Mullen. Shoots. And he just missed with a low shot. Canucks Reinhardt sees Smith. He's in with a drive. Hit the goal post.
net, but one fly from the blue line and caught by Vernon and hit the post. Ducks nearly on top with that shot. Still tied at two. 10:30 left to play in the second period. Seventh game of the series. So she's up for grabs tonight. And down in Los Angeles, we'll be joining them for their game right after this one. The Oilers and the Kings in their seventh game. What a night on CBC television. Bozak comes in. Trapped it ahead. It's dropped back now. Good play by the Canucks. They get it in front, but everybody covered. Kept in for Sandlin. McCowan took it from him. Then he lost it. Fleury gets it up to McCowan. Flipped in on the right side. Tim Hunter goes in. Lipster on top of him. Hunter fell. Got back up. McCowan is there to help him. But it's Nordmark who takes it away. He went a little too high with it. Tried to put it off the glass to get it out.
Doug Smith takes a long shot, but the puck's rolling. This drives you absolutely crazy. Comes at you like a knuckleball. Rolling puck goes through Vernon's legs. Got a little piece of it. Hit the post and stayed out.
That was close. New and back. And Roberts has scored for the Calgary Flames. Nordmark and Linden. Linden's goal here in the second period. Tying it. Flame covering on a shot from an angle. Papinski fighting for it on the boards, gets it to McDonald. He put it in around the net. Adams is coming back for Vancouver. He was slow in making his move, but he does get it up to center ice. And McGinnis fires it back in. The plane stopped it. Garth Butcher. He has Otto in front. Pass goes to the corner. Up along the boards to center ice. And again, McGinnis was there. But he missed McDonald with the pass. Linden backs up in his own zone, played it in front of the net. Butcher gets it out to Tanny. He shoots it ahead, and Adams couldn't see the pass. Linden got away from a hit. It was coming from against. Long pass to McDonald, just missed it. Down the ice it goes, and Linden against Roberts gets it out. Skriko is turning. Good move by Skriko, moving it in. Across the line, here's Sutter, and his shot missed on the short side. Otto turning. Roberts coming up with him. Roberts takes the pass and going in is Lube. Otto trailing the play, lost it. Three Canucks on this rush at center. McCown after Sutter. He dropped it back and McCown made a great effort. But here's Sutter again. Around the net, Rick Sutter tried to jam it in. Sutter kept it in there. Skriko! Right in! Oh, and he did everything but put it in the empty net. He waited and waited. In behind to Vernon. And then there was no one. Skriko made some great moves on that last shift. Nearly got a goal. Trying it again. Smith shoots a high shot. Didn't miss by much. Here's a chance for Mullen. And right at the net, Connor McLean, who was out smartly to cut the angle. And he just held it. Now watch this for a chance.
Great stand-up goaltending. Watch Vernon. Stays on his feet. Stays on his feet. Follows Skriko all the way across and then made the save. Didn't commit himself. Great patience. Good stand-up goaltending.
McKrinnon was back there in the crease. And a teammate along with him. But you're right, John. Vernon just stood up and skated all the way with Skriko. Canucks seem to be coming on here. Gets a chance, shoots it right on, and McLean stopped that. At the blue line, McGinnis, a shot. Oh, it just rolled by the open side. Here's the shot by Erzin, right in front of the net again. Now the Flames are pressing, but they get it out. The defenseman Butcher on the rush. Tried to shoot it in by McGinnis. It hit McGinnis. Adams after it, but Bullen was there first. Headed ahead to Patterson from center ice. He lobs it in. 6:45 remaining in the second period. Chances at both ends, but they're still tied 2-2. That pass too far for Sandlin. Good lead pass, but he wasn't moving. McClellan with Fleury. And that goes back inside the Calgary line. McCrimmon
put it on the board for Tim Hunter. He is stopped, and the play is called.
Al McGinnis takes a shot from the point. There's a maze of players in front. It hits Gates, but the Canucks do a good job. They don't let it get through, and it just trickles wide. Paul Reinhart making sure that nobody gets that shot from Al McGinnis.
McGinnis with that big booming shot. He put it in low. It was deflected and nearly caught the far corner. Bozak stopped near center. Tim Hunter didn't see it in time to make the play. McClellan reaching forward, and here's Fleury. Fleury comes up over the line, looks over in front of the net. McCown shot. It was deflected high. McClellan bumped by Bridgman. Bridgman comes back to dig it out. Bridgman skates away to the corner and along the boards to the blue line. Bridgman from center, trying to shoot it in. He got it by everybody. Sanlak is in there and missed it. Nordmark moving up, took a hit to McClellan. Sanlak gets in front, is upended, sweeps it back as he fell, and the Flames shoot it down the ice. Once again, it'll be ice in with Robert Nordmark back to touch it. 2-2 to score with 5:34 left in the second period. The Vancouver Canucks have outshot the Calgary Flames 12-9 so far in this period. They've had some dandy scoring chances. The great one by Skrikal. But Vernon stayed up and got a lot of help. The defenseman back there with him, Skrikal, skated around everybody. Now the Flames. Led by Otto, just shoot it in. Kopitsky goes in. Reinhart slapped it away for Tandy. He just dumps it out of the zone and down the ice. It does not make the goal line, so the play continues for McGinnis. Ahead to Papinski, and he shoots into center ice. Tandy is bumped at the line and knocked down by Nekras. McGinnis behind the net. McGinnis plays it ahead. Got by everybody to center ice, and Tandy turns, dropped it back to Butcher. To the other side, Reinhart. Across center, Reinhart goes in, shoots. Stick save by Vernon, no problem. Nordmark will stop it near center ice. Gets it ahead to Linden. Linden coming in, he feeds it off on the left side. The Flames are back to break it up. Sutter couldn't stop the play. Nordmark has to come in. Goes all the way down the ice again. Lipster to pick it up, but he lost it. Sutter got back in time to get a skate on it. Right wing pass is Nordmark. He's forced back by Lube. Lube, Roberts, and Neuendijk on again for Calgary. Sutter with Bradley coming in. Skrikal is the other winger for Vancouver. In back of the net, this is McCrimmon. For Roberts, to Lube. Hit the linesman. That gives Lube a break. Now Roberts, and he missed the far side. Neuendijk is flattened in the goal line. Fans wanted a penalty, but they keep going at it. Skrikal didn't see it. Neuendijk slapped it in, and he goes off as they make changes. Roberts went back at Nordmark, and there might be a penalty against Calgary. Roberts bumping with Bradley now at the far side. Sutter back to pick it up. The net is empty. They have the extra man on it. They can keep control, but they won't. McCown rifled it and hit Roberts, who will be getting the penalty. He's lucky he didn't get two. He went after another player on the delay. Roberts for roughing at 16:41.
Referee Bill McCreary has let just about everything go. There's the hit by Roberts. Nordmark holds Roberts' stick, but it's the retaliation penalty right in front of the referee. You can't do things like that, especially in a seventh game.
It's a 2-2 tie with 3:19 left in the second period, and Vancouver will have the man advantage. And tonight, well, the power play has been dynamite.
It has been the difference tonight. 2-for-2, they only had one power play goal in the previous three games played here, and that was a meaningless goal in that second game that they lost 5-2.
The he came into this game, John, scoring 5 goals in 41 chances. Now that's just a little over 12%, and that won't do for any kind of success. But they're doing it tonight with 2 power play goals. They have another power play now, a chance to take the lead. Nordmark through the middle, Nordmark doing a good job. Lost it now. Nordmark back. He waits. Nordmark is fooled by Reinhardt, who comes out against Patterson. Slides it up to Linden. Trevor Linden didn't find any room against Al MacInnis. The puck to Linden. He keeps it onside. Tried to shoot it along the boards and did. Now the Canucks pass it around. MacInnis doing a pretty good job. Coming back to pick it up, and here's Nordmark. Slapping it back there again. It's up the side of the net. Adams picked it up off the boards. Gets it back to Nordmark, to Adams again. Adams moving up. Looks back, not much room for a shot. Or is there? He decides to pass off. Linden's shot to the side of the net. It was tipped all right by Burning. Loved it, and he hangs on to it with Reinhardt in close. And 54 seconds remaining in the penalty. 2-2, 2:13 left. Vancouver, the man advantage. They could not win the draw. It's slapped out of the zone by McKinnon down the ice. 45 seconds left in the penalty. Roberts of Calgary is in the penalty box. Reinhardt quarterbacking the power play. Lobbed a pass through the middle. It's broken up and fired to center ice. Skrico backs up with it. And it's Otto stealing it. And here's Mullen. Mullen steps in over the line. Fake the shot. Mullen going for the net. Now he's around the goal. Looking back to McCown, who takes his shot. That hit the skate of Nordmark. Sandlak brings it over center. Dumped the high one in wide of the net. Bradley going in against McCrimmon. McCown was back to help. And it's out of the zone. 5 seconds left for the penalty. Roberts is ready to come on the ice. The fans finally make a little noise as they salute the fans for killing that penalty. Sandlak shoots it off. McCrimmon to Gilmore. Gilmore to Roberts. He's on the fly with Lube. Lube goes in, but Roberts was in offside. And the play is called again with 1:03 left in the period.
Terry Crist trying to get his team rolling here. They're playing Vancouver's game. The fans finally making some noise as the Flames killed off the first penalty they've been able to kill off tonight. The fans, I don't know whether they think that they're saving it for the next series. They don't get involved. This could be the last hockey they see this year.
It has been rather quiet. They say the better way for the Calgary Flames to play is the physical game, but they're leery on penalties. Well, you can still play the physical game, no doubt. There's Roberts, and he's doing his best, but he's getting another penalty for it. Butcher and Roberts bumped together. Now, who is getting the penalty, Butcher or Roberts? Roberts went after Butcher. They collided, and lo and behold, it's Butcher who's going.
Again, another retaliation penalty. Roberts goes. McCurry will call it retaliation. There's Butcher with his stick up. Hauled him to the ice. Gets a high sticking penalty.
Butcher in the box at 19:05, and the Calgary Flames with an opportunity to take the lead as they get their shot at a power play. 9-35 in the series. The Flames. 1-1 tonight. Stats for you, as we just told you. So the Flames get a chance to improve on the power play and in this game. A lead going in to the third period would be great for Calgary, of course. Ramage kept it in his goal. I think it hit Harold Snips.
Disgust on his face.
miss the net. Mullen gets the goal. A power play goal for Calgary at 19:25. And they lead 3-2. Butcher in the penalty box as that goal was scored. And now icing called against Calgary, only 25 seconds left in the period.
The only time all year the Calgary Flames have lost and they've had the lead going into the third period was in game one of this series.
And that one was won in overtime when Reinhardt scored. The Flames are tough, taking the lead in the third period. And the Canucks know that. With 24 seconds left on the clock now, they'll do it again. In that spot to the right of Hunter. The winner of this game, of course, meets the winner of Edmonton, Los Angeles, and they'll hook up in their seventh game later tonight. We'll be joining them to show you that game. Smeal trying to center it, hit the side of the net. Smeal after it. He does center it, but McCrimmon is there. 15 seconds to play. He tries his shot in for Kirk McLean. Goaltender moves it the other way, and Butcher has it with 5 seconds left. Smeal fired it in. It goes out to the corner away from Adams, and the horn goes to end period number two.
Mel Bridgman with a good chance in that second period. I would say Mike Vernon has had the tougher saves of the two goaltenders. Mel Bridgman was in so close he couldn't do anything with that puck, but Vernon was in perfect position to make the save, as he has been most of the series. Even when his team has been ordinary, Mike Vernon has come up with some great playoff goaltending.
Great save off Tandy in the first period. Skripal in the second period, among others. It's the close-checking type of game you expect from the Vancouver Canucks. They look for the opening, and they'd like to get one early here in the third period. That is Butcher shooting it in. Ozak chasing it in front of the net. So McCown dumps it out through the middle down the ice. Reinhardt coming back. His pass starting to play to Sandak, and he just got rid of it. That was put it up with the stick of Reinhardt. Reinhardt going in. He shoots off the shoulder of Vernon. He got his arm up and stopped that one. Deflecting the puck high onto the glass. Reinhardt allowed to walk right in there. Gilmore flipped one into the corner. McLean coming out of the net to stop it for Snips. Skripal lost it. It's centered. Lidstrom's there against Patterson. Now Snips in the corner. Laid it out. Took a hit as he did. Bradley's coming in. Bradley in on McCrimmon. McCrimmon chased him behind the net and pinned him there. Sutter gets it loose, however. Centered it. It hit a skate, and McGinnis brought it around the net again. Mullen chopped it away, but it's kept in by Snips. Bradley back in the net. Nobody in front. Bradley trying to step in front himself. Gets it up to Snips. His shot. And that's stopped by Vernon. He just holds it.
Calgary fans have seen this before. Paul Reinhardt goes right around Vic Mattress, in on a short goaltender. Where do you go to short goaltender? Up top. Vernon stays on his feet and just gets a piece of it.
3-2 Calgary. 18-11 remaining. Face off to the right of Vernon. Rossiter drops it in, and the Flames win the draw. Ryan McDonald is away, racing in. He tried to shoot it in. It just rolled into the goaltender. Here's Adams on this side. Starting back out the pass all the way down the ice when McCown touches it. It'll be called icing against Vancouver. So the Flames, John, continue to look for that big break, and they'd like to spot Linden open somewhere near center.
Trevor Linden started this season as a winger, really came into his own when the injury to Barry Peterson forced him to take over at that center spot. The Canucks finally have that big, strong centerman that every team would love to have.
Faceoff Faceoff deep in the zone to the left of McLean. Big Joel Otto in for Calgary. He has McDonald to his right, Pavlinski to his left. And they drop it in, McDonald went after it. Here's his shot by Pavlinski, came close. Pavlinski fell. Adam skates back down the left side. Scoop one in for Stan Smeal. Vernon saw him come in. He's upended as he came out of the net. And the Flames clear the puck. Natras steps in. Can't find any room. Looks around. Natras feeds it off to the corner to McDonald. McDonald is jammed in on the boards. Otto is in front of the net. And it's Smeal bringing it out. Gets his far center, backs up a bit. Now Linden, long shot, he just missed. He had Vernon cutting out and cut the angle. And he went for the stick side and missed it. Butcher with Fleury chasing him. Lifts it away to center ice. Smith picking it up, able to drive. That's deflected wide. Adam shot, that hits the net. And it's cleared out by McCullough. Getting more life into their game now. Moving up. Tanny. And that's stopped by Vernon. Tanny again. Adam shot. Tipped out by Vernon. He's been busy over the last two shifts. Here's Fleury now coming in. Fleury's drive. Picked away by McLean. It's still in there. Fleury in front of the net. And McClellan just missed it. Fleury again. And down goes McLean. He hangs on to it. Fleury had three or four chances, but McClellan had the best chance.
Good pressure by this third or fourth line of the Calgary Flames, depending on what you want to call it. The puck bounced past Ryan McClellan, right in front of Kurt McLean, tried to take it on his backhand. There's a shot, big rebound. Now it comes through and hit Lindstrom, hit Fleury, and there's McClellan, tried to take it on his backhand instead of his forehand, and missed it. Another chance for McClellan, and there Kurt McLean follows the puck, is able to make the save, hangs on to get a whistle.
Calgary with Nieuwendyk at center, Roberts and Lube. Mozek can take the faceoff. Bridgman was out of position. Sandlack on the other wing. That was quick shot. That hit Lidster in the face. He cleared it, goal. Comes up on the play. Lidster poked one in for Vernon. Hampers takes it around the net. Went by, snaps with it. Nieuwendyk doesn't get up in time. Lidster was back. McCown stopped by Snips. Canucks shoot it in. Bridgman playing it off the boards into the corner and around the net. Roberts missed it. Lidster shot. And Vernon was out again, cutting the angle. And the rim protecting the goaltender as he went down after making the save. And he held it, and Mel Bridgman was in close, of course.
Again, Vernon and McCown get tangled up. McCown has to watch the puck, and he's nailed by Big Jim Sandlot. Vernon gets out, cuts down the angle. There's Sandlack again, trying to create some interference. Quick concentration by Mike Vernon. Follows it, even though he's being hit.
And the Flames hang on to that one-goal lead.
Greg Adams sitting on the bench. Another cut just above his right eye. A couple of stitches already in place. Seems to be oozing a little blood.
15:47 left in the third period. Bozak squaring off against Otto on this draw. Bozak got it away to the right side. It's flipped toward the net and McGinnis. He's had a strong game tonight for Calgary. Al McGinnis lifts it high over everybody to the right of the net. No icing. Jim Benning back, starting the Canucks out. Gilmore was in for checking. Once again, Benning. And again, Gilmore stopped him. Now Lidster for Bridgman. Back to Lidster, up as far as center, feeding it into Bozak. Sandlack with it. Bozak falls down. Sandlack after it. He's bumped on the boards. It's back to the line.
Can Benning get set? Put a shot in. Another chance for Benning, but he had to slap on it. And the Flames get out. Mullen comes to center. Left side with Quinlan. And he missed. Had a great chance. McClellan fired it up behind the net. Sandland takes his time going over. Then was hit by Gilmore. Ducks get it out, though. As they near the six-minute mark of the third, it's still a one-goal game. Calgary on top. McClellan now. He missed. Adams back out. Through the middle is Norton. Runner Linden dropped it back. Oh, Vernon came out to cut the angle, and Reinhart stepping in there again. Smeal on the play. Into the corner, Adams trying to dig it out. Reinhart. In deep, and Smeal dropped back. It's stopped by Butcher, but no, it did come outside the line a fraction. And they're offside, play call.
Again, the Flames defense backs up on Linden. This allows Reinhart lots of room. And the puck jumps up just as he went to shoot it. Vernon got a piece of it, steered it to the corner.
14-11 left in the third. Oilers-Kings game will be getting underway in about 20 minutes from now, and we're going to Los Angeles to show you that game in its entirety. Second seventh tonight, Lewis comes in, flipped it in, and McLean steered it away. Brantley missed the pass. It's knocked down at the blue line by Reinhart. Brantley shoots it in for Vancouver. That's Merzen back, gets it out of the zone, down the ice. And it just missed the goal crease. So as Butcher goes back to pick it up, it's icing called against the Calgary Flames. Sent for the faceoff to the right of Mike Vernon. 28-27 of the shots on goal, Flames. The slight edge in that department also. Otto. Pass to Patterson. Mullen up there. Going in after it as it came off the boards. Lidstrom back. It's tipped out of the zone. Smith tried to move in by Gilmore, who had him covered. Now the pass. Too far for Gilmore. Lidstrom again. The Nordmark. Adams in. Shoots. Stopped by Vernon. It's Lidstrom keeping it in. Patterson had him covered. He couldn't get a shot on the net. Dumped it off to the corner, and the Flames get it out. 7 minutes gone in the third. And it's coming in. Nice save by Vernon. Made it look easy. It was a tough shot, though, on the short side. Can't get it out. Lipster moving in. Score! It was harmless looking. Lipster moving in. But it hit a skate in front of the net. And that evens it up in that department for the puck going in off the skate. And we're tied.
Again, the Flames can't clear. Doug Lister does a good job keeping it in. I think Brad McCrimmon hits his one into his own net. There's the shot from Lister. You see McCrimmon. He's got his stick on the ice. It's almost like he's shooting it in his own net. Lister just slides it for Tony Caddy. There's McCrimmon, stick on the ice. Gets it by Mike Vernon. The Flames left his own too early. Lister jumped in. Here's McCrimmon off the stick. Pass Mike Vernon.
So 3-3. Lidstrom getting the goal, and this one will go unassisted at 7 minutes and 12 seconds. So 12:37 remaining in the third period of the seventh game here at the Olympic Saddle Dome, and they're tied 3-3. These Canucks never say die.
Doug Lidstrom, his first of the series. This makes up for the Harold Steps goal that also you consider a fluke. Lidstrom's off McCrimmon's stick past Vernon, and Joey Mullins went off Harold Snep's skate past Kirk McLean.
Lube along the boards trying to squeeze it out. Reinhart stopped it. He put it to the other side, but Roberts saw that develop. Neuendijk is moving up. He's covered. Now Brantley tried to set it up, but Roberts hit him. He has been one of the more physical forwards on the ice tonight, Roberts, of the Calgary Flames. Belting everybody. Reinhart through the needle is Brantley. Brantley trying to go around. Netquist. Here's Roberts. Straight down the wing. cuts in through center. Roberts trying to split the defense. It's broken out. The Canucks are very careful with their game plan again now and dump it out. And that goes all the way. So that's icing against Vancouver. This series was tabbed earlier with Crisp and McCammon going at each other as a series of words and a war of words. War of words now, I'll tell you. 11:40 remaining in the third period of the seventh game. And the score, 3-3. Lanny McDonald moving up on his play. Sweeps it around the net and shakes off the check. Dumped it behind him, but Bozak got back. McDonald trying to stop Bozak. Kapinski is there with him. Fired in, McLean stepping behind the net. Lidstrom takes over and is hit by McDonald. Kapinski got it back first and shot missing the net. McDonald is ducked in the goal mound. Bridgman right wing pass. Sandlak is moving out. Herzen took it away from him. Sandlak trying to get off as Herzen comes out of the zone. Herzen all alone. Nobody stopping him. Oh, and he just missed. Three Canucks on this rush. That's Smeal coming down. Smeal shot. And it was deflected and the play is called again. Good rush by Merzen. No, he went all the way end to end.
Now Gilmore only has 3 points in this series. One of the disappointments for the Calgary Flames, although in his defense, and an abscess jaw, was hospitalized. And Gilmore, 5 assists. One game against the Norris Bears. The Flames were looking for more offensive production, but you look back to the teams Gilmore played on. Even though he got some points, he was their defensive specialist.
Yes, and he has been killing a lot of penalties in this series. And he's worked very hard in that department. 10:47 remaining. Canucks. Butcher's shot. It's deflected away. Reinhardt deflected right in front of the net, and Vernon made a nice stop. Here's Patterson now, one man back. Patterson dropped it to Mullen. And his shot missed. Patterson centered it. And McLean looked very cool, covering up. He lost possession of it, though. Gilmore looking for it. Flames keep it in. Patterson working in the corner. Gets away from Butcher. He centered it. Mullen now against Butcher. Centered it again. And the Canucks. Adams picks it up and gets it ahead. Reinhardt skating in against Nadler's big move. Reinhardt in front. Centered. Oh, what a chance for Linden. Reinhardt, a beautiful play. Reinhardt again. Reinhardt working hard. Tried to set it up in front. And the Flames get it out. 9:50 remaining in the period. Reinhardt going off, but he was all business on that last shift. Nordmark got a pass ahead and hit the skate of Smith. Flames play it back in or outside. Lube and Lundin, who was inside the line. And that stopped.
Vancouver Canucks, and he's been doing all year. The Calgary Flames panic. As soon as Natras is beaten, Reinhardt, a nice touch pass to Linden. Now all 5 Calgary Flames come back. There has to be some Canucks open someplace. Look at the white sweaters. All 4 of them in there watching the puck.
Puck shot in and bouncing off the boards. Had a long shot. I'm a town to stop. Canucks get the Flames back outside their own line. Moving it down, and Tanny goes in after it. Amaka breaks the shot. Stopped in front of the netminder. Newendek is racing in there. Coming back is Jim Benning. He did a good job hustling back to stop Newendek. Tanny rolled it off the boards and in. Out of the net, Vernon. He played it up to Lube. Lube and Fleury now coming up. It is Lube trying to go in back to Fleury. He couldn't get his shot. He was off balance. Now he centers it. Lube just missed it. McGinnis's shot hit the side of the net. Lidstrom around the goal. Fleury chasing him. Lidstrom poked it ahead. And Smith gets it down the ice. Icing has been waved off. Vernon got it away from center. But the Canucks were in forechecking. Now the fans get it out. Nappers ahead. McKellen got it up over the line. And he was stopped by Bradley. Still inside the line. Here's his shot that's deflected by Bradley. And it's clipped right to the netminder by McClellan. And Kirk McLean holds it with 8 minutes and 19 seconds remaining. In the third period, the score 3-3. Fleury hooked into the boards. That's where Reinhardt was parked. Bozak with him. That's Butcher in the corner. Tip near center. McClellan slapped it back, but Reinhardt is moving up on it. Reinhardt coming in. He tried to do it himself, and as he fell, slapped it toward the net. Here's a shot that's deflected by Sandlin. Sandlin again back to the net. Bozak trying to get it back in front. He's covered by McGinnis. Fell on the puck, and the referee standing there calls the play as Bridgman was tied up by Fleury. If the tension hasn't gotten to these players here in Calgary, it has gotten to the fans. They're sitting there, not much noise. Somebody tried to get a wave going a while ago, but no such luck. They nervous or what, John?
Right from the start of the game, it's been like the old Pacific Coliseum when they used to play for the Canucks. It's like playing in a morgue.
Seventh game. The Stanley Cup Series. Score tie. What do they want? 7:45 left in the third. Maybe they're scared.
Sure they were, but I think they could have helped their club had they come in with some noise early in this game.
Minor injuries all over the place. That's Butcher being attended to on the bench. McCown behind the net. Cleared it out. McDonald is on the line again as Papinski brings it up. Dumped it in. Here comes McDonald looking for it. Trying to pick it up. Fell. Now he gets it. McDonald played it back to the goal for Papinski. Smeal is over there bumping his man. Papinski got it back, and McDonald missed it. Cleared down the ice. Smeal can't catch up to it. Covered by McCown. Here's Danny McDonald again. In with Papinski. The pass to Papinski. Tipped away by Nordmark. McDonald again. Comes back with the pass to the line. And the shot hit McDonald. Smeal is turning with Skripal. Smeal flipped it in as the Canucks want to make changes. 6:55 remaining in the third period. A 3-3 hockey game. Here's Gilmore looking dangerous, but it's poked away from him just as he was about to make the play for Patterson. Gilmore hustles all the way back. Now Mullen is turning. Here is McGinnis with that big shot. Shoots! Right in front! And McLean somehow picked it up. McGinnis can literally put it through.
Now McGinnis from outside the blue line almost beats Kirk McLean through the legs again. Here's the shot. McLean's looking for it. It trickles through.
He can handle the puck, but he didn't say he could do that. I thought he was reaching to put him across the red line off into the corner. But he said, no, I got to hook it in and smother it.
Kirk McLean's had a few go through his legs in this series. That would have been the biggest one so far.
3-3, 6:25 remaining in the third period. Up along the boards and out in again with Lidster. Played it up across center. Here's Roberts now coming the other way against Lidster. Put it in front where Lube and Neuendijk were cruising. Neuendijk is pushed off the puck. Gets back into it. And Roberts is there to help him. Bradley comes back to help for the Canucks. He gets it. Passes in front of the net for Lidster up to center. Lidster shoots it in. Canucks make changes. Erzin turning in the corner. Here comes Roberts down the left side. Sutter bumped him, and the puck got into the goaltender McLean. Sutter in the corner. Roberts after him. Sutter slapped it along the boards. It's just out. Flipped back in. Flames cannot touch it. Offside will be called. They won't get a chance as Reinhardt starts centering. He flipped it off to the corner. 5:25 remaining. 3-3 the score. McLean will head will stop this one. It was tipped right down to him. Butcher around the net. McDonald in there to hit him. Now Bridgman coming away in center. Got it up across center. It's Sandlin trying to move it in. Bridgman there with him. McCrimmon fired it away. McDonald is bumped. But he gets a chance to clear it out. McDonald does. Flip it to center ice. Sandlin lost it to Fleury. Looked dangerous, but Fleury didn't control it. High one goes into the left of the net. McClellan giving chase. Nordmark gets away and lifts one down the ice. 4:40 remaining in the third period of a 3-3 tie. In game seven at the Olympic Saddledome. Not on much tonight, but he's on now. Tim Hunter shooting it in. Going for the net. Smeal is on it. Canucks sent three players away. Up to center ice. It's dropped back by Linden. And a shot flipped in by Adams. And Vernon simply catches it and pulls it. Erzin now having a few words with the youngster Trevor Linden. Erzin giving a push to Adams, who comes in to help. McClellan there also.
Stan Smeal immediately was right in front of Trevor Linden. The Canucks don't want to see Linden go off. Even if he takes somebody with him, he's their main man. They've got to keep him on the ice.
Well, it comes down to this, Bob Buchanan. 4:18 left to play in the third period. And you've battled these first-place overall Calgary Flames, you and your captain, Stan Smeal, down to that time left in the third period. And you're tied in games, 3-3. You're tied in shots on goal at this point, 32-32. And it's 3-3 on the scoreboard. And you know, Terry Crisp can't stand the anxiety no more than Bob McCammon can. But it's down to this, folks. Stanley Cup fever. Seventh game. 3-3, a little over 4 minutes left in the third. You think the next goal, by whomever, is not a big one? None bigger, I wouldn't say. Up for these two teams this season. Here's Adams working up with a shot. That's kicked away. Linden going after it. Vernon out of the net, picked it up on the boards in the frame. Smullen getting out. Now with Kopinski and Otto. Otto going for the net. There goes Smullen, but the pass was intercepted, and Linden is turning. Trevor Linden moving up, trying to solve the Calgary defense. At the line, it's kept in by Tanny. Mullen had a chance to clear it, and did not. It's Otto through center to Mullen, who knifed it in. Gilmore is on the ice, so the Flames are making changes again. A pass intercepted at the line as Tanny gave it away. The plane out of the net. Fleury giving chase. Nordmark striding out of his own zone to center ice and coming up over the line. He dropped it, but not in time. It was called on the offside with 3 minutes and 20 seconds left to play in regulation time. This one could be winding up any minute now. 3 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in the third. Gilmore back. This is the time these players are very uptight and tentative. Nobody wants to be a goat in this kind of a situation. So they'll be checking carefully. The crowd is still almost quiet. They're trying to get something going. 20,062 are scared to think of what is, what might happen here at the Olympic Saddledome. There's Skriko in trying to forecheck the Flames into an error. Nappris goes behind the net. Skriko giving chase. He nearly picked it up. Nappris looking for it. Two Canucks in there. Sutter was one of them, and he missed it. Butcher stopped it up the line and took a shot. It's blocked in front. And two Flames get up. They've got three. Mullen moving up quickly. Takes his shot. Rebound! And the Flame was careful with Otto cruising in. And Patterson was bumped in front of the goal by Butcher.
Good chance for Joey Mullen. He let the shot go from the wing. He was playing for a rebound. It came out, but the Canucks did a good job picking up their men. 3-on-3, Bradley comes back. Mullen takes the shot. There's Patterson, taken by Butcher. Who gets a stick on it? Not much. There's Otto. Bradley's got him. Good coverage by the Canucks.
There's the shot from the angle, and you'll remember the other games. There were a couple of goals scored from that angle by the Calgary Flames. Not this time, though, with 2:32 left in the period. 3-3 the score. Seventh game in the series. 2.5 minutes, and it might be decided. They're out of position on that faceoff, so they'll do it again. McGinnis and McCrimmon are the defensemen. Roberts, Duvendijk, and Lube. The Calgary lineup, everybody up. Ozek on the rim of the circle. And that is Bridgman in on the draw. Anxious for Knox, the referee, to drop it in. He does. And he won the draw. Jim Benning and Lidster are the two Vancouver defensemen. Lidster goes along the boards to get it out. Bridgman is moving up on it. Ozek is going for the net. Bridgman had to hook it off to the corner. Roberts in, and he bodied Bozak out of the play. Lube tried to shoot it out. He got it out and down the ice. Benning takes his time coming back. Now hustles. With 2 minutes remaining in regulation time, Vancouver and Calgary in a seven-game series. Sandlak missed it, but Bozak pops on it very quickly. Trying to go in. Sandlak up on the play. Lube is stuck. Puck fired back of the net. It'll be McCrimmon. Old cleared with 1:40 left in regulation time. McCrimmon played it ahead. It's knifed right in on the net. McLean stopped it. Here's a steal. Roberts shot. And he missed the far side. Sandlak. Trevor Linden again on the ice. Linden shoots it in. The Canucks were making changes, so he's up there all alone. 1:24 left in regulation time. Kopinski stopped near center. Hauled down. And Linden feeds one in. Linden went after it. Linden looking dangerous. And he took the backhander. It was deflected. Linden again, right in front of the net. And McDonald on the ice for Calgary, bringing it out. Crowd gets into it now. McDonald centered it. And the shot by Otto went wide into the final minute of regulation time. Linden coming across center, and here's Reinhardt. Reinhardt and Adams. Oh, what a save by Mike Vernon. Folks, you won't see a better save than that by a goaltender, given the circumstances. 48 seconds remaining in the third period of a seventh game. Watch it.
Right through Rick Natras's leg. Vernon still picked it up and picked it off.
What a save by Vernon. Whoa. Terry Crisp with his shirt open. Tie loosened. And Mike Vernon has to have his tie loosened. Certainly he did not choke on that one. What a great pressure save it was by Vernon. 48 seconds left. Puck to the right of Mike Vernon, where they'll drop it in, and here it is. These Canucks come very close to winning this one, this game, and this series just seconds ago. Bradley and Sutter go after it back there. 35 seconds remaining in regulation time. Look out, Mullen is on the board. He overskates it near center, dropped it back. McCrimmon is allowed to step in over the line. He dumped it to the corner with 25 seconds left. There is Reinhardt poking at it. Can't get it out. Reinhardt moving at it again. But it's Mullen who tries to center it. Now Bradley is skating away. Not much room, so he shoots it out. 12 seconds remaining in regulation time. Here's Gilmore moving up. One last chance. He centered it. And it goes through the crease, and we've got sudden death overtime in this seven-game series coming up. Killers against the Calgary Flames. Overtime at the Olympic Saddle Dome in this game seven. And it's Merzen who'll shoot it in. McLean out of the net, who's steered away. Sandlak does not catch up to it. Merzen dumped it in again. Reinhardt coming out.
You know both teams are thinking fast goal. You wonder if they can take the pressure. And they pray for a fast goal. And I'll bet there's not a vehicle moving on the streets of Vancouver at this moment. All glued to their television sets, hoping for this miracle to be completed. Otto's shot deflected into the stands.
Wonder about Otto going into the next series, a grueling seven-game series for Joel Otto. He's been out there as regular shift, killing penalties in every key faceoff. And the LA Kings and Edmonton Oilers, you think the people in the Norris division would just be licking their chops, hoping that this one, the next series, goes seven games also.
Talking about the streets being deserted in Vancouver, probably not a fly moving in the streets of Calgary at this moment either. Imagine these two, 43 points apart in the regular season, and tied in overtime here in Game 7. Goes to show you.
Kaplinski took that long shot, everything fired at the net. You never know in overtime. Vancouver Canucks, they had a great year anyway. They came back with a 59-point season last year, 72 points this year, 74 points this year. Correct myself here before I'm sure my producer would correct me. Jack Backlar, he says it's so much fun to be around this club because they are all overachievers.
Doondang Roberts and Lube have been a threat all evening for Calgary. They're on the ice now. Lipster, the defenseman, is bodied on the play. Richmond tried to tie up his man and did. And Bradley got it out as far as center ice. End of the Calgary blue line. McCrimmon dumped it back in. Canucks come back. Sutter comes in to help. And went by him and McCown down the ice. And McCrimmon being watched by Spreakall. Long pass on an open side. Bradley misses it. Bradley gets it again, it was Sutter. Bradley takes a shot. Vernon makes the first stop here in second half overtime. Butcher coming up with Sutter. Sutter stopped by Roberts. He and Lou get together. And it is Roberts. But stopped by Reinhart near center ice. McCown against Tandy. That went out. Here's Gilmore. And out of the net comes McClain. He saw Gilmore alone and stepped out very quickly. Gilmore trying to keep it in, but Merzen stops it at his own blue line. Ahead it goes down the ice. Icing will be called as Butcher goes back to pick it up ahead of Gilmore, and the play will be moved down to the Calgary zone for the faceoff. Joel Otto on the draw for Calgary, winning it. Merzen scooped it high to Mullen, out to Patterson. Patterson in the center ice zone. McGinnis fell. Tried to sweep the puck in by Butcher. It got in there. But Reinhart is racing against Mullen. Took a swing at it. Patterson was in front of the net open. And he got in a pass. Puck floats out to center ice. Merzen backhands it in again. He missed the game in Vancouver, Merzen. With a bad knee. Doubtful starter tonight. He's played a strong game for the Flames. Tandy shot. Gloved by Vernon. He fell. And McCown luckily was back there to pick it up. Gilmore again. Pass ahead. McCrimmon moving up on the play to Joel Mullen. Cutting for the net. Mullen tries to center it. Back of the net. Gilmore gets in front of the goal. But the Canucks are covering up in fine style back there. And they get it out. Richmond coming in as sideline. Going high and missed the top corner. Blocked by McClain. McCrimmon will try to keep it in, but he was bodied off the puck by Bridgman. McCown bumped by Sandler. Bridgman fires it in. Vernon will come out of the net to stop it. We're into the fourth minute of overtime. Puck near center. Nobody saw it until Poprinski jumped on it. Reinhart logging a lot of ice time now. It's Trevor Linden coming in. Quick shot is blocked by McCrimmon. Puck tipped down the ice. 10 Hunter racing, but Butcher got back to Adams. Adams with Smeal coming in. It's dumped in, but they're called on the offside of the Calgary blue line. This one, 3-3, the overtime score. 1-1 in the first period at Los Angeles. Here's Roberts knocking one out of the air. Roberts going for the net. Shot hit the side of the goal. Adams against Lube, and Lube stopped him. But now, Adams' second effort got it out. It's fired back in. Butcher and Roberts is coming in to plow into him. Butcher's a big guy, though, took the hit. Now he and Roberts go at each other. Several punches were thrown. Minor shots, and they're going off. Both of them, I say. Roberts and Butcher. You don't see that often in overtime.
Both players trying to get the other one to retaliate, take a penalty. It happened earlier in the period. Roberts took a penalty, and then Butcher took a penalty. Here, Roberts runs at Butcher, doesn't get very much of him. They come together again as the puck goes over the boards. There's Butcher and Roberts. They both have their sticks and hands up, and both of them block.
Roughing penalties at 4:29. Gilmore comes on again. Gotham brought immersion. Screenshot! And that came close. Flames on it. Gilmore centered it. Canucks trying to hang on now. And they do to get it out to Bradley. Gilmore's after him, though. Bradley shoots it from center ice. Vernon stepping out of the net for McGinnis. McGinnis played it up on the boards. It's stopped by Sutter. Sutter into the corner with it. Screepo got his stick on it. But he's covered. Two Flames will come off the zone. It is Patterson and Mullen. Mullen dropping into Patterson. Gets a shot away, but was blocked. Canucks turn to come out. Bradley leading this attack with Screepo and Sutter. Coming in. It's Sutter. A pass! Oh, and it's sold by Vernon. A game-saving, series-saving game. Stake save by Vernon. How about Alfred? Erzin lost his stick and kicked it in. I'll tell you, folks, Vernon made a hot one in the dying minutes of the third period to save these Flames. He just saved them again with a skate save that was sensational. Kopinski turns up to McCullum, and it's blocked by McCain. A rebound. Oh, and Otto came close. Otto going after it. Otto digs it out. Seven. Scramble in front of the net, and the Canucks hang on to get it out. Steered on the line and out. Pass through center. Didn't work. Nordmark spun around but shot it into the zone. We've had great scoring opportunities here in Sutton and overtime. But we're still playing, as you see. Hunter is offside.
The season save for the Calgary Flames right here. Petri Skrinko, the leading scorer. Saved by Mike Vernon.
None better. No doubt. Kicked out the left skate. I don't know how he could see it. It's out the move. Fleury coming hard. He's over the line and shoveled it off to Lube, who had to wait at the blue line. In back of the net, they're trying to dig it out. Nieuwendyk is there battling for it. But it's cleared away by Bozak to Sandlak and out to Bridgman. He tried to backhand it in over the line, but got it high at the Vancouver bench, and that's where the puck is. But we're still going at it. Stepping up is McGinnis. Drilled a hot one off the glove. Up Kirk McLean.
Down!
Smeal waits. Nieuwendyk hit him. The two players are on the ice. And the puck is frozen. The play stopped. Face off inside the Vancouver blue line. Steps shaken up in the last game. A doubtful starter tonight got into the game, but obviously found it difficult to move and has not been out here in the overtime period.
Had one shift in the third period. He struggled. We were noticing in warm-up he was having trouble turning, but Harold Steps, professional that he is, knowing how important this is to his club and how well he's played, gave him the old college try.
Sudden death overtime. Otto shoots it in. LA is leading at their home base against the defending champions. 2-1, we'll keep you posted. Up the center and coming in is Adams. Adams got to the ice. Burson going around the net, he fell on his own accord. Smeal shoots one deflected, it went high onto the glass. Reinhardt takes a shot on a rolling puck. It is centered. A brilliant save by Vernon. Now Smeal trying to come around and jam it in. Put it on the outside of the post. Oh, my. Gilmore shoots it in. Reinhardt back. How can they stand the tension? Butcher along the boards for Sutter. Gets it out. Down the ice by McBrennan. Here comes Skripal. He was showing great speed to get in. To knock it up into the corner. Bradley missed it. And the Flames shoot it down the ice. Lidstrom back and Gilmore watching his every move. It's to Sutter. Broken up by McBrennan and Patterson. Shoots it from center. McLean jumps out of the net in a hurry to stop it for Nordmark. He stopped. Couldn't reach it. Lube again, but it was offside. Lube says no. Prosecutor of the linesman says yes. Guess what? The play is dead. Can you believe Joe Mullen?
Robert Nordmark popped up the puck right in front of his own net. And McLean, in desperation, he was beaten on the play. Here's Nordmark. Look at how casual Rick McLean is. Nordmark loses it to Gilmore. There's
save in overtime. This one he kicks out from center ice. If you beat him from 3 feet, you won't beat him from 100. That was a little triumph. Luke might triumph. He comes in. Luke upped it back, and it got by Fleury. Three Canucks are up on this play. This is Adams coming in. Adams going for the net with Smith. Oh, and a big save by Vernon. It's still in there, centered. Vernon got his stick on it to move it. He can't clear it out, but McGinnis will. He get the center of fire. Here it comes. Picked away by McLean. Fine style. Fleury knocked it in. Nobody was in front. Reinhardt shoots it down the ice. It's going to be icing. These goaltenders are something else in overtime here at the Olympic Saddle Dome.
Six shots on net coming into this overtime period. By far the most on either team. Stan Smeal tries the wraparound. Hits the far post. He had his hands up in the air and he thought it went in. Adams passes it out front. Doug Smith going to the net. It hits a stick, but it hits Mike Vernon on the way by.
Good stuff by Vernon. Good stuff by McLean. We're tied in overtime. Look out. The Flames winding up with Mullen. Now rolls to his skates. Long shot that was screened and McLean saw it at the last instant. Lidstrom got it out to Sandlack and he plays it off the boards to center. Played over 10 minutes of sudden death overtime now. Puck again up on that ledge. Got over the glass. 2-1 in Los Angeles. The Kings are leading the defending Stanley Cup champion Edmonton Oilers in the first period. We're going there when we're done here. 2 7th games in Stanley Cup play. Everybody felt the Cup playoffs would be terrific this year. Folks, they are. And we're just in the first round. More to come. Hockey Night in Canada on the CBC network will be there with you all the way. Don't worry, be happy.
Long pass through the middle, down the ice. Sanlak is coming in. And back is Gilmore. And icing is called. Sanlak obviously missed it.
The Canucks complaining, saying that should have been an icing call, and Sanlak did touch it, but Crimmin made sure Sanlak didn't. And the Flames have an opportunity deep in the Canucks zone. Bob McCammon has to be pleased with the outcome. No matter what his team does, he has to be proud of his club. Blues coming in, and they have played a whale of a series.
No, you get this far, you've got to win. Both coaches feel the same. Chris was supposed to win. McCammon was not given much of a chance. Now they both have the same chance. High stick stops the play. Face-off just outside the Calgary line. Trevor Linden again on there for Vancouver. Waved out, apparently. Slow getting the stick down. It is Nordmark. Or no, it's Adams who'll take the face-off. Flames won it. It's tipped down across the line. Butcher moving back against Otto. Here comes Smeal. His pass dropped up the line to Linden. Linden got it in front. Oh, Vernon got a piece of that. A good play by Linden to move it over in front of the net. Right in the crease. Mattelin stepping out over his own line. Smeal after him. He backhands it in. It goes to the net where McLean stopped it. Flames are in forechecking. They're a little more physical with their forechecking than are the Canucks at this stage. McGinnis sees Popensky alone. He gets it up to Nieuwendyk. Nieuwendyk centered in McLean. And a save by McLean on the short side. Here's Bradley. Bradley stepping out smartly. He's the center and shoots it from there and it's in. Canucks make changes as the Flames go back for it. Puck gets by Nordmark and down to Lidstrom. Lidstrom turns, played it ahead. Sutter is stopped, gets moved. In with Roberts. Lube to Roberts, it didn't work. Lube went after it on the boards. Bradley trying to get it out. Does, poked at the center. Slapped back in by Nieuwendyk. Nieuwendyk stopped Bradley from moving on it. Lube turns, shoots it from center ice. McLean out of the net. Nordmark was back to give it to Sutter. Sutter's pass going by Bradley. But moving up again is Lidstrom. Street ball throws it off to the left of Bradley. Bradley gets it back. Into the corner, Street ball. Street ball trying to hook a bit of skate. Sutter went in there to help. Street ball now trying to get loose. Defenseman but can't, and Sutter was skating back all the way. He got it up to center. Flames shoot it in again. Butcher comes back, takes it from the net under McLean. A little over 7 minutes in the first overtime period. Up to center is Smith, picking a hole, shoots. Build a high one at Vernon. He has made sensational saves in his overtime. He's not about to let one go past him from the blue line. So anything can happen. Surely that settled in overtime. Canucks on the draw had a chance to move in. Tandy did not. Patterson gets it ahead to Mullen. Mullen got it across the line, but he is offside and the play is called.
Mullen is so good with his feet. We saw that the last game here. On his goal, he kicked it up there. He tried the same thing. He did not have control of the puck as he went across the blue line. That's why that was blown down by Gord Russell.
The tension in the building, of course. Just look at some of the fans. No more fingernails. Terry Crisp running on a ballpoint. His nerves must be frayed. Not to mention the cannon. On the other bench, Flames come back. Patterson deep. Couldn't get it by Lindstrom. He kept it in, rolled it in wide of the net. Sanlak is going in. Mullen gets it up to Gilmore. Gilmore is leading the rush again here in overtime. He shoots it in, and McLean fired it away. Here's McLean. Scores! The net is off the Magnets. No goal. No goal. The net was not off the Magnets. The puck was shot from inside the line, but the net was off. And McCurry, the referee, having a busy night.
From the Calgary bench, and that was definitely off before McCowan even wound up to take that shot. McLean plays it off the boards. There goes Patterson into McLean, knocks the net off. There's the shot from McCowan.
The net was dislodged, no question, and the puck comes in after. So we've solved nothing yet. 6:18 left in the first overtime period. Face off to the right of McLean. 44-39 of the shots in this hockey game. There have been some gillies. McCowan tries it again, and it's stopped by McLean. And shot through traffic. You never know with the crowd in front of the net. And McCown decided he'd try it from the blue line. Linden couldn't stop his man, Tim Hunter, from shooting it in. Here is Smeal and McCown bumping. Trevor Linden gets on the move. Linden coming up on Tim Hunter, dropped it in through the middle. The backhand shot is gloved by Vernon. And Vernon pulls it. What this is all about. Stanley Cup play. A lot of pressure. McCrimmon coming back to the side of the net. Move it up to Patterson. He didn't see it. Otto did, though. Otto was stopped by Smeal. Reinhardt on the ice. Pass up on the right side for Smeal. He's going in all alone. The experienced one. But Mike Vernon now makes this crowd over 20,000 feet. How well they should be.
The Calgary played, they caught a line change. I don't know how they caught a line change in overtime. Here stands Neal all by himself. He tries to go high glove side. Doesn't get it up high enough. And Mike Vernon makes the save. Here's the play. The Flames are changing. Smeal's all by himself. Sits down for him, tries to go high, doesn't get it up, and there's Vernon with that big left hand.
I don't know which of the saves Vernon has made here in overtime will go down as the save of the game. I think you can wrap them all together. Burt McLean gave it away to Loop. Sutter was there, and he couldn't clear it out. Lindster hurried it off the glass. It does get out to center ice. Robert shoots it back in. And a long pass down to the line. Against Krikko's shot, gloved by Vernon. On that angle, Vernon covered it. Roberts, second chance to move it out by Bradley. Got it up to Duendijk. He was across center ice, so that is offside. And they'll go back inside the Calgary line for the next faceoff. Stan Smeal will wonder for a long time, should his team lose this game tonight, why he missed.
He has struggled in the scoring department this year. Had only one goal from January 7th till the end of the season. That was in the very last game. There he had a great chance. He had so much time and couldn't get it up.
Butcher from the blue line. High shot. Vernon saw it this time and grabbed it. McCown trying to gallop away. His pass stopped. Here comes Tandy. He got a chance. Another great save. How can he keep doing this? Another brilliant save with the glove. That shot was labeled on the short side. Oh, brother.
Tony Tanney with a great chance. And again, Mike Vernon with the left hand. Stays on his feet. High top shelf. Short side. And Vernon's right here to grab. Good
his stuff tonight. And it is some kind of stuff. Loose off inside the line. 4:36 left of the overtime. Butcher's shot. Knocked down. Adams. That's blocked. It's centered. Mullen coming out with that knock. Mullen coming in. He's got Nieuwendyk. And Nieuwendyk is stopped. But Mullen is on the puck again. Put it over in front of the Canucks. We'll get out. Three of them. To center is Tanny. Whipped a pass in before he hit center ice. So that'll be icing against Vancouver. 4:08 left in the first overtime period.
You really get the feeling that the Calgary Flames are hanging on. Mike Vernon has prolonged this past the 15-minute mark of overtime, and that he's been the only reason that this game series is not over.
They told me before we started this series that Vancouver likes to play a defensive-type game and look for their spots. Well, folks, they played a fine defensive-type game tonight. And I'll tell you, in this overtime period, every second, almost, was one of their spots to pick because they've been coming at Mike Vernon. He's had 44 shots, 45 by the Flames in this game so far. 4 minutes left in the first overtime. Puck down the ice. No icing this time. So Sanlak will race in there to give McGinnis some trouble. Mullen comes over on the boards. Patterson is there. The Canucks have it. Another chance there for Sanlak. He couldn't make the play. It's dumped in behind the net. McCrimmon, but the play had been called offside. Back at the blue line. That was close. Face off just outside the Calgary line. Lidster scored at 7:12 of the third to get us into overtime. And only 3:45 left in the first session. And the scoring chances we've had in overtime. Oh boy. Lidster now from center. Vernon gloved that. Erzin takes it around the net. Goaltenders tend to make the long shots routine. I don't think they are in overtime. Nothing routine. They sure look that way. Bozak is offside.
Imagine trying to pick three stars in this one. I'm glad I don't have to. While McCammon shouting encouragement to his team, they really carried a team of Calgary Flames during the overtime. The Flames, they look tired. Bigger, stronger team, but they do look tired here in the overtime.
The pace that the Flames set earlier, I think, has slowed a bit. You're right. Maybe that's one reason the Vancouver Canucks are allowed to come at them a little more in this overtime. But the Flames have had chances, too. Here's Butcher now bringing the puck over center. A long shot off the glass. It bounces around on the other side. Flames will clear out. Down the ice it goes. The Penske goal is offside. Fans do not think so. It was back inside the Calgary line. Foot down across center. 3:10 left.
Terry Crisp, being an ex-player, also can't vent that frustration. And I think the tendency is you try to do so much as a coach instead of letting the players try and decide it. You can see the anxiety on Terry Crisp's face.
Linden, Smeal, and Adams again for Vancouver. Linden going after the puck in the corner. McCown got a piece of him. It's cleared outside the line. Butcher shoots it back in. McCrimmon picks it up. To McCown. It's fired into the Vancouver zone. There goes Tim Hunter after it. But they catch him. Adams got back in time. Butcher against Kuklinski, who's trying to kick it loose. Tim Hunter back in the net, trying to dig it out front. He's covered. It comes in front of the goal. And Smeal brings it out as Linden covered the man in front. Linden feeding it up over the line. Offside called at the Calgary line. 2:33 left.
They have to be so careful on those passes from behind the net. That time they passed it, the Flames passed it out, and the Canucks turned it into a 3-on-2 because Joel Otto was tied up in front of the net.
Wonder did Bob McCammon tell him another joke at the start of overtime. It It's been a habit of his through the series, as he says, to keep his team loose, going up against the first-place Calgary Flames. It has worked. So far, they're in overtime. And only 2:25 left in the first overtime period. Here's Gilmore stealing it. He settled it on his head, and that's blocked in front of the net and cleared along the line, but not out. The Knights were a little shaky in their own zone. Again, still shaky. Gilmore, Mullen shot, that's blocked. A scramble for it. Gilmore again trying to go in. Mullen takes it. Fires off the boards, and it's Lidster who'll clear it out of the zone and down the ice. Icing will be called when Merzen comes back. But the Canucks look very shaky on that last series.
They got the puck to Joey Mullen. That's who they wanted to have it. But it was blocked in front by Doug Lidster.
1:51 left in the first overtime period here in Calgary.
Gilmore to Mullen. Here comes Lidster. Sacrifices the body and makes the great block in front of Kirk McLean.
This is a great chance for Calgary. They had the Canucks tied up inside the blue line. Making changes now. We're set. 1:51 left. They win the draw. The Flames do. McCrimmon shot. It's blocked. Bridgman takes his time. Gets it ahead. Ozek rolled it into the zone, and Sandlak is going in after McCown. The goalie out. Clearing it along the boards. Sandlak feeds it over back of the net. Another chance for the Canucks with Bozak. He didn't see the pass. McCrimmon played it ahead. And they shoot it out across the line to center. Canucks dump it back in. 1:20 left in this first overtime period. McCown in the corner is bodied off the puck. Bozak comes in to help Bridgman. Bridgman gets loose. Tried to play it away from Nieuwendyk and could not. Nieuwendyk is grabbed and turned around. He got the puck out over the line. The Roberts, he is alone, and McLean is out of the net to knock it away. Tried a shot. Linehart was back there into the final minute of this overtime period. And we've seen everything in this overtime session, but no goals. Loop shoots one in. They're after it again. Papinski going in. Score! The Calgary Flames have finally done it. Not a pitcher goal. It was centered by Papinski. It hit it. Stayed in front. And it's over. The Calgary Flames, behind the goaltending of Mike Brunnen, will be unquestionably the star of this game. Defeat the Vancouver Canucks 4-3.
Joel Otto, I think, is going to get credit for this goal. Charged the net, and Papinski just threw it into the maze of players, and it bounces past Kirk McLean. Doug Lidster makes a mistake at the blue line, knocks it down. Otto takes Lidster's stick down. Papinski's in by himself. Watch Otto on the left of your screen. Goes to the net. He hits Otto's skate. No chance for Kirk McLean.
Flames, if we give an extra grip on the handshake to these Canucks fellas, because they weren't supposed to be here. Well, they were here. You know it better than we do up here. And they nearly kept going in these 89 playoffs. But Vernon made sensational saves in overtime to hold the Flames in until that goal by Otto at 19:21. They finally credited to Otto from Papinski and Lube at 19:21. 46-45 the shots. Flames 4-3 the score, Flames. And this series is over. Calgary wins it.